Welcome back to MMA Inside the Cage. Still got that UFC Africa 24 preview coming up next round, but let's talk TV. Not Breaking Bad, not Walking Dead, not Dallas, Casey's favorite. There's actually a new MMA reality show that is seriously sweeping the globe. Got its start in Australia with a show called Wimp to Warrior. Casey, tell us all about this absolute hit going on down under.
Well, we've all seen shows like The Ultimate Fighter and Fight Master, which are geared towards the discovery of the world's top unsigned talent, but Wimp to Warrior brings an entirely new approach to the reality show format. Here, we watch the trials and tribulations of individuals pulled directly off the street by Aussie MMA coach Richie Cranny and transformed from regular people into legit cage combatants over the course of 20 weeks.
Well, I got to see this. Let's take a look at a snippet from the show, Wimp to Warrior.
If you want to learn to be an MMA fighter in Australia, one of the best to talk to is Richie Cranny.
People can sit there and judge and shout comments at people that are fighting, but unless you've done it, you've got no right in giving your opinion on these guys. So I think these guys are going to go through a massive journey. And look, fighting, I truly believe fighting is 80% mental and 20% physical. The physical we're going to get, but most of this training is going to, the warrior is a mental, it's an inner thing. It's a presence that we're trying to bring out from them. And I think everyone's got it within them. Some come out quicker than others, but I think I'm pretty confident all these guys are going to be standing very tall at the end of this, and it's really going to change their lives.
Now, Canada has actually gotten into the game, Casey, but their show's called Cubicle to the Cage. Same concept, I'm guessing. What are the differences?
Well, similar concept, but very different in that Cubicle to the Cage is told not from the coach's perspective, but rather through the eyes of Boyd Sharp, an average 9-to-5 office worker who sets out on a one-year challenge to learn and compete professionally in the sport of mixed martial arts. On top of this, he also reeled in a crew of young and old to participate along with him. I just finished watching the first episode, and it's uncanny how it embodies so well, that feeling you get on the first day of training.
Well, let's take a look at it as well. There's this little sneak peek here from Cubicle to the Cage.
My name is Boyd Sharp. I'm 38 years old. I'm an IT guy. I've never been in a fight in my entire life. Never thrown a punch in anger. But in 1 year, I'm going to get in a mixed martial arts cage and fight a professional fight.
Question is, does he have the heart? Does he mind pain? Does he mind being hit? That's the big thing. That's what separates a fighter from someone who just trains. If I had a nickel for everybody who told me I wanted to be a fighter, I wouldn't have to teach.
We're hardwired for combat. I want to know what possesses a human being to decide they're going to dedicate their lives to training for getting into a cage and pounding another person unconscious. When I told people that I was going to do this, they said, A, you're nuts, and B, can I come too? So we're going to try to involve at least a few more people than me in this and give them an opportunity to challenge themselves and see how they come out on the other end.
To check out Wimp to Warrior, go to wimptowarrior.com.au and also on their official YouTube page. Then keep up to date on Cubicle to the Cage at cubicletothecage.com. Feature fighter of the week time, and usually we profile the up-and-coming fighters in each organization, but this time, I think we got a hidden gem here. Alexi Alanik, the boa constrictor, is set to meet Dion Staring at Pro FC 50 on October 16th in Rostov Oblast, Russia. Now, Casey, Alanik has this huge record, and it looks like he's been in the cage with some of the biggest legends in the game, but he's still not like a big name in many households.
Well, this is a seasoned professional here. Alanik made his pro debut way back in 1997 and has gone on to amass a 47-10 record, at least from what I can tell. This guy was fighting way back before today's recognized databases, so it could be even more extensive than that.
Well, in this fight, Daryl Schoonover couldn't make it, so you got Dion Staring instead. How do you think this one irons out there in Russia?
Well, this is an extremely well-matched fight. These two are very close in age, and Staring possesses a lengthy record of his own. I think in this one, however, that the recent activity of Alanik makes the difference here. The boa constrictor has had 5 fights in the last 6 months, which puts your competitive mindset on another level.
I agree. Now, ProFCWS, that's the website for more information, and you certainly don't want to miss that event on October 16th.